And this is the trunk of this Survivor. Key's been replaced. Dirt GT, the molding looks beautiful. You see all the details of the taillight assembly, virtually untouched. Wiring harness. Sealer. And this even has the little contact strips on it still. They even have the original grease on the hinges. Fuel filler. You notice on the fuel filler, have that blue marker right there. Part identification, you never see that. Look at this angle, you can see the body dip line, plain as day. We've already recorded all the Deci stamp numbers in the trunk. Body dip line. Underside's all original. Again, the original grease, that is the proper color. You can see the crude sealer. Right there is the Deci stamp number for the drop. We'll get a good photo of that when we're underneath the vehicle. We'll get up on a lift here in a second. You can see the body dip line. Plain as day on the back there. Hey, I'm here today at Jim Ridge, Jim Ridge's place. You know Jim, you know alternators and starters, you know Jim. Best in the business when it comes to that. So this is a 1969 Dodge Dart GT, which we started to talk about a minute ago. It's in excellent condition. You see the bright work. You know, it's a little minor ding there, but it's virtually flawless. All the side chrome. There's the body coat tag. Here is the copy of the build sheet. It was found in the rear seat. It was in great condition. Been through the inside of the car. It's pretty amazing. 45,000 miles on it. The only defect that we could find is right here in the driver's seat. Some of the stitching is coming apart. Let's see if we can, we just had it on the lift, so we can't really get all the way inside this car. We already were once up under the dash, and you know, this is certainly a benchmark vehicle when it comes to the finishes, the condition of everything under the dash. Take a look at the primer. Primer is outstanding. Look at that. Like it's just come out of the factory. Door panels are in great shape. Doors close like new. Glass is all original. The guy that did have the car changed out to some weld wheels. The original wheels and wheel covers are available. Jim does plan to put those on. Here's some of the jack hardware and the wheel covers that were on, the deluxe wheel covers that were on the car. Something interesting I'll point out here is some inspection marks. I have seen this before and we'll share it with you. You can see the bluish green on the bolt there. Now it's gonna be a little trickier. There's the same paint on the back side of the inside of the right hand seat frame. Of course, we already went through the engine compartment once, we'll go through it again. And as you can see, the carburetor is intact. Nobody's really fooled around with it. We have some aftermarket wiring there. We're going to fix that up in general. Again, we know the fan needs to be changed, fan shroud, but everything else is original. Of course, Jim's already checked out the starter and alternator. Those are original to the car. The rear shocks are original to the car. The front's been changed. The right hand upper and lower, all the ball joints, in and outer tie rod ends on the right side are all original. On the left side, the inner and outer tie rods have been changed. All the AC hoses are original. The vacuum hose to the master is original. Of course, we already looked at that. The wiring harness, ID tags, we've already documented all that. original master cylinder. And as you know, on this side of the master, we'll see if we can pick it up. There's some of the production numbers, manufacturing identification numbers. Hose is all original. Car just needs a good cleaning, which I'm sure Jim will be getting after that here shortly. Lastly, what I'd like to show you is this grill. It's one of the nicest original grills I've seen. Headlights are original, so look at the detail on how the black is done. A little bit of wear down there. That's how it's done. See where the cut is? Right there. Cut in right there where the black stops. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you see Jim, give him a shout out.